I was scrolling through YouTube to find anesthesia related videos, and this video popped up on my feed that said, "I'm afraid of surgery," in quotes, "baby cries, anesthesia." I was curious. Now the baby is not going to cry saying, "I'm afraid of surgery." However, I thought this is a useful video to walk through what exactly happens when a baby goes in to have anesthesia. The fun begins now. Namaste and welcome. I'm Dr. Rajiv Iyer, a child anesthesia specialist doctor, and I do videos related to anesthesia and operation in children. All right, let's see what's going on in this video. This baby seems to have a cleft lip, which is like a break in the lip due to failure of fusion of the normal lip element. All right, the baby is brought into the operation theater. The anesthesia doctor is ready with everything he needs to be. He's putting a mask on the baby's face to get the baby off to sleep. Now the mask has oxygen and the anesthesia gas flowing through the mask. So the anesthesia gas that's mostly used to get babies off to sleep is called sevoflurane, which comes as a liquid, and then it passes through oxygen as a gas and gets into the body of the baby. Now the baby is crying. Obviously the baby will cry because the babies won't be happy if someone is like holding a mask on their face, and this is normal. Someone got an electrocardiogram, leads on the baby, and this is standard part of the monitoring under anesthesia. That's done. Now the anesthesia doctor is saying give some fentanyl, which is a pain medicine which is usually used during operation to help with pain for the baby. So the baby already came with having an intravenous line, or maybe they did not show that part. What is going on here? Let's see. Okay, additional medicines are being administered. Now everybody is watching the monitor, and this is just a standard part of the procedure where they make sure the baby is safe. Now you see the anesthesia doctor is pressing a black bag. The baby wouldn't be breathing normally because of anesthesia, everything would be stopped. So that's a way of giving breathing to the baby. The breathing is taken over by the anesthesia doctor. The mask has to be held pretty tight, otherwise the oxygen will leak around the mask. Enough oxygen will not get into the baby. And that's exactly what the anesthesia doctor is doing. They seem to be a very experienced crew. Alright, they're still watching the monitor. What is going on? So they may have given a muscle relaxant medicine, and depending on what medicine is used, it takes about 3 to 4 minutes for the medicine to work so they can put the breathing tube in the baby. Anesthesia is a very critical thing, and that's the responsibility of the anesthesia doctor, who is constantly watching to make sure your baby stays safe and comfortable. Okay, they are speaking Tamil, which is a southern Indian language. And this video is from a hospital in southern part of India, but the principles are exactly the same, no matter what part of the world you're in. Okay, alright, they're seeing what breathing tube should be put in the baby. So the breathing tube comes in various sizes, as small as what is called as a 2 mm tube, all the way up to probably like 8 or 9 mm tubes, which is like a really big tube. Now there are a few ways to determine what size breathing tube should be placed in the baby, and in this case I think they're measuring the thickness of the finger to see what size breathing tube should be put in the baby. The breathing tube should be optimally sized. It shouldn't be too small, it shouldn't be too big, because both of those have their own problems. Now that instrument is called a laryngoscope that is being placed, and that is required to place the breathing tube in the right spot. Okay. Now the anesthesia doctor is trying to get a view of the trachea with the laryngoscope, trying to move it. And once they get a good view of the trachea, then they put the breathing tube in, which is exactly what is going on, because the breathing tube has to be put in the correct place. It can also go in the esophagus, which is the wrong place. And once the breathing tube is in, it is checked by providing ventilation, seeing for chest rise, seeing for what is called as end-tidal carbon dioxide on the monitor. Alright, looks like the tube might be in the correct spot. I see the chest rise. Now they're going to secure the tube with the tape. Alright, they're showing the monitor during the process of intubation. The oxygen saturation might have come down a bit. So they are ventilating to bring it up to 100%. So it is now at 81%, which is on the lower side. Now the anesthesia doctor is putting a stethoscope to make sure the breathing tube is actually in the right place, trying to bring the oxygen saturation up. Now they're discussing, is there a spasm? Why is it taking so long for the oxygen saturation to come up? Just by looking at the video, it's hard for me to say what the exact reason is, but there are a few causes that can lead to that. So they got a breathing tube in, they're trying to get the oxygen saturation up, and once everything is done, the tube is secured with a tape, a white colored gauze is put in the mouth, and that is to soak up any blood that comes up during the operation, so the blood does not go into the stomach, which can actually precipitate vomiting when the child is waking up. If you found any value with the video, make sure you hit the like button. If you're interested in videos related to anesthesia and operations, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. Do check this playlist out for other videos related to anesthesia and operation, and also left them in the description below. Take care, stay safe. I will talk to you soon.